Intervertebral disc disease is a process by which there is degeneration of the discs that lie between the bones of the spine. These discs act as shock absorbers to reduce the impact that daily activity has on the spine, and they also provide stability to the vertebral column. You can think of the intervertebral disc as a jelly donut. There's a jelly-like center and then a fibrous capsule on the outside that keeps the jelly in place. In our veterinary patients, the jelly may degenerate over time, meaning that the jelly-like material will become dehydrated and fill in with a rough, gritty material. The dehydrated disc material may rub away at the fibrous capsule and cause it to thin. Over time, even with normal everyday activities, a small hole may tear in the fibrous capsule, allowing the gritty material to push up into the vertebral canal where the spinal cord sits. This is what's called a slipped, ruptured, or herniated disc. When this occurs, the tube-like spinal cord experiences compression. Although there are different types of disc herniation in dogs, the degenerative type that I've described, called a Hansen type 1 intervertebral disc disease, is the most common. The degenerative process may happen at an early age in some predisposed breeds, like dachshunds. Although IVDD is possible in cats, it is far less likely to occur in cats than in dogs. Clinical signs of cervical intervertebral disc disease can be quite variable in clinical appearance and severity. Many dogs with cervical IVDD may present with neck pain as the only clinical sign. Neck pain typically manifests as a low head carriage, an arched back or kyphotic posture, spontaneous crying or yelping, and muscle spasms in the neck. However, a variety of other clinical signs can be caused by cervical IVDD. In some cases, this disease can cause weakness in all four limbs, a wobbly or ataxic gait in all four limbs, holding up of one of the thoracic limbs, or in severe cases, an inability to move the legs. In very severe cases with IVDD in the caudal portion of the neck near the shoulders, dogs may have difficulty breathing. This is because the nerve that controls the diaphragm exits the spinal cord at this level and may be affected with severe disc herniations. For cervical IVDD, we use a grading scheme of 1 to 5 to assess the severity of clinical signs. Grade 1 means that our patient is only experiencing pain. There's variability in the severity of neck pain, but this grade indicates that there are no deficits on the neurologic examination. Grade 2 means that there is weakness in all four limbs, but that our patient remains able to walk on their own. They appear drunk and wobbly when they're walking. Grade 3 means that all of the limbs can move, but our patient is too weak to walk independently. Grade 4 means that the dog is paralyzed and cannot move all four limbs, and this is very severe. Although grade 5 is the most severe category and indicates that the dog cannot move all of the limbs or feel the toes, this is very uncommon to be the case in cervical IVDD and is much more common in slip discs in the back. Cervical IVDD is diagnosed with advanced imaging. Although radiographs may suggest IVDD, advanced imaging is required to confirm the diagnosis. Additionally, an MRI is superior to a CT scan for diagnosis as it helps to identify the soft tissue structures that comprise the nervous system, such as the spinal cord, the nerves, and the discs. A CT scan is unable to properly assess these structures. The MRI also helps to differentiate from other possible causes of the clinical signs seen in IVDD, as many disease processes can present similarly in a clinical setting. It is important to rule out other causes so that we are certain that we can formulate an appropriate and effective treatment plan for your pet. There are two main management options for slip discs in the neck. The first option is with surgery. So surgery typically provides great chances of curing a slip disc, and it's the most direct way to relieve the spinal cord compression. But surgery comes with the need for anesthesia, and it comes with the small risks associated with any surgical procedure. After surgery, patients usually stay in the hospital with us for anywhere from 3 to 7 days for post-operative pain management, some rehabilitation, and monitoring. A period of rest is going to be required at home after surgery, but most dogs are typically feeling really well when they are discharged from the hospital. The second management option for cervical IVDD is a more conservative option and requires rest and medications. With the conservative approach, our goal is to allow the hole in the fibrous capsule of the disc to heal over in order to minimize the chance of additional disc from slipping out. The rest period is also going to allow time for the material that has already herniated to scar down and become less irritating to the spinal cord. Strict rest is the most important part of this approach, and we typically recommend that the first 4 weeks of recovery are in strict crate confinement. We also typically utilize medications including neuropathic pain medications, general pain medications, and muscle relaxers to keep our patients comfortable during their recovery. The prognosis for cervical IVDD is generally favorable. Depending on the severity of clinical signs and the treatment option elected, prognosis for recovery can be as high as 95%. Each case is different, and your neurologist will be able to guide you in order to make the best decisions for your pet. We hope that you find this information useful. Cervical disc disease is a very manageable problem in our patients, but without timely intervention, it can progress quickly and can cause irreversible spinal cord injury. If you're noticing any signs of intervertebral disc disease, such as neck pain, difficulty walking, inability to walk, or any other concerning signs, we strongly recommend that your pet be brought to a veterinary neurologist as soon as possible. That way we can give your pet the best chance of a successful recovery. We are open to neurologist staff 7 days per week in order to provide your pet with the best neurologic care.